the show, B-Show Festival. Yeah. And an artist and a composer himself would have a conversation for around 20 minutes, and then we'll have Q&A. So without further ado, let's welcome Kit.
Thank you. First of all, thank you very much everyone for coming, and thank you the Chinese Society to bringing this film here. It's really an honor to show my film here. This is my first feature film. It's actually produced almost like 9 years ago from now. But I still have a very intimate personal feelings on this film. Before we start watching the film, I would like to tell you two stories that inspire me to make these films. It's nothing about the story itself. So it happened in Switzerland. One day when I opened the newspaper, there is a title reading, dead body found on a Swiss lake. There is a lot of lake in Switzerland. So in the village that I live, there is a dead body found on the lake. And the police bring the body back to the office for investigation, and then they look up the missing, like the missing people, you know, record. And then they find out this body might actually be someone who actually it was missing 18 years ago, because the Swiss lake has a very low temperature and it's, you know, very clean. So the body is actually preserved very well. So they call the family, which they think the body belongs to. And then the family suddenly go to the hospital and verify this body is actually their father, who disappeared 18 years ago. By that time, for these 18 years, they haven't been able to say goodbye to their father, even though their father have been missing for 18 years. They still keep all their father's belongings by the door, like, you know, the jacket, the coat is always by the door. His father's slippers is always in the by the doorway. The pillow is always there. The watch is always in the same place. The ashtray is always in the same place. After identifying the body as a sign of saying goodbye, they will be able to pack all their father's belongings in the storage and, like, finally to say goodbye to their father. It comes to, like, during this time, I was thinking about making my first feature, and then I experienced the first time in my life somebody is really intimate, also passing away in my life as well, which is my partner's parents. It's very interesting because my partner is Swiss, and then his parents do not speak English, and I do not speak any Swiss official languages. So every time we met, we are just, like, you know, smiling or, like, you know, being very friendly to each other. But then I spend a lot of quality time with them. For example, I spend Christmas with them. We go to a lot of family events, and then by all this body language communication, we develop a very special kind of intimacy. On the day they passed away, even though I know in my mind, in my brain, that they already passed away, my body or my unconsciousness is still telling me every day I wake up, before my conscious come into my mind, I feel like I have to give them a call, or I have to go, this Sunday I have to go to their home to have family dinner, or this Christmas, what should I prepare or buy a Christmas present for them? So that kind of intention has been, or this kind of desire of reaching them, even they passed away, has been persist quite a while. Even though, you know, consciously, I know they already passed away. So this film is actually about this struggle between the consciousness and what I call the unconsciousness, of how do you balance these feelings of knowing somebody passed away and the unconscious of desiring to get in touch with people that's already passed away. It is not a movie that is made for traditional narrative understanding. So try not to force yourself to understand the narrative, the story, but try to feel what is the story about. This story has a lot of time jumping, and this is actually about this protagonist, this Chinese character, who see everything that he see in the Swiss village, remind everything that happened in Hong Kong, the love story that was happening in Hong Kong. So we are actually in, like, imagine we are actually inside the guy's brain and seeing all this, how these little items, related or not related, just bring up the memories of what had happened. Okay, so this is like a brief introduction. I hope you enjoy the movie.